Linda woke one morning from a strange dream and informed her mother of being taken to Mars to be trained to fight in a war. A war between Martian Colony Corporation and an indigenous Martians for the last 7 years as a teenager. She told her mother that she traveled to a military base on Mars where her unit engaged in territorial battles with the native reptilian and insectoid Martians. She told her mom the dream was true. Her mother thought she had cracked and had watched too many sci-fi movies.
How long?
Whatever.
Violent or gentle?
You decide. Linda woke one morning from a strange dream and informed her mother of being taken to Mars to be trained to fight in a war. A war between Martian Colony Corporation and an indigenous Martians for the last 7 years as a teenager. She told her mother that she traveled to a military base on Mars where her unit engaged in territorial battles with the native reptilian and insectoid Martians. She told her mom the dream was true. Her mother thought she had cracked and had watched too many sci-fi movies.
What was the purpose of troops on Mars?
There were three primary purposes for sending secret military-like troops to Mars: to establish an extraterrestrial defense for Earth, to claim Mars as a U.S. territory, to get Martians accustomed to having Earthlings present on their planet. Through the underground tunnels and came to a large dome, about the size of the Superdome or Astrodome. We lost all communication with headquarters when suddenly, doors all around the edge of the arena opened and out charged the Reptoids, swinging large bladed weapons. It was like being in a blender. Linda was one of about 35 who survived.
There are two main indigenous intelligent species on Mars, reptilian and insectoid. At Linda's initial briefing, he was told these were native savages and beasts. However, she soon learned that they were evolved species, each with their own culture, civilization, and intelligence. Their homes are mostly underground, and Linda frequently referred to them in interviews as living in hives or nests. At first, the indigenous people treated the humans from Earth as neighbors. As long as their nests and hives were not disturbed, there was no problem. They seemed more interested in maintaining their territory rather than fighting. Even so, there were frequent skirmishes. The humans and Martian natives became weary of fighting and actually signed a treaty agreeing to peace.
I want a reliable answer. No certainty possible. Index of probability 15%.
When her 20 years of service were up, she spent several weeks on the moon for a reverse aging process so that she could be returned to Earth and inserted back into his original timeline. 2017. Her memories of her 20 years of service were suppressed and did not return to her for many years.
We'll be right back.
the space suit. The radiation in that suit is deadly.
I'm getting all kinds of electronic signals. The meter's starting to go crazy. I don't understand it.
You will stay here, right? Hold it, you're coming with me.
Yes, Captain.
Thank you.
here. Think about it. Do you know what you're doing?
Have you heard about David and Goliath?
Yeah. Oh.
Doesn't matter. If we make it, I'll tell you the whole story.
In the sector HF203, and the zone is not isolated any longer. The radar sentries report that no flying objects have left Earth's orbit, while an aviation scout has seen large metal segments scattered here and there on the ice field.
Call a press conference. Give them press release number 2 that we've isolated and destroyed the enemy spaceship. And you can burn the other messages.
Okay, Commander.
Nah. Marseille is a nickname. In the Valley of the Rhone, you don't have megalopoli, but only small towns. Montpellier, Haarp, Marseille. My grandparents came from Marseille, but I was a nickname of Marseille. Carlotte sur le villageois.
Vite, Marseille. It's Mac.
Oh, he gets you.
Let's bring him in. Give me a hand. We'll get him to the dispensary. Easy. Oh, great. What did it?
She's hurt. Oko, we're in the infirmary, but we have to get back to the bridge.
Yes?
Will you send someone down to take over?
Don't worry, I'll come down myself.
Linda was one of approximately 300 girls and boys who were covertly drafted to participate in the program. Girls comprised only 20% of the group, a male-female ratio that remained consistent during her entire 20 years with the SSP. Linda recalls that during her childhood, she would be taken from her bed at night. Even though she would be gone for days or even weeks, she would be returned to her bed and travel back in time to when she was taken. He would wake up as though no time had passed, feeling like he had just had a really, really long dream.
Thank you. long time.
I won't try to talk you into changing your mind. I only ask that you behave justly. Allow the crew to choose. It's the only democratic way, I feel. That certainly does seem the fairest way to handle this, doesn't it?
There are two main indigenous intelligent species on Mars, reptilian and insectoid. At Linda's initial briefing, he was told these were native savages and beasts. However, she soon learned that they were evolved species, each with their own culture, civilization, and intelligence. Their homes are mostly underground, and Linda frequently referred to them in interviews as living in hives or nests. At first, the indigenous people treated the humans from Earth as neighbors. As long as their nests and hives were not disturbed, there was no problem. They seemed more interested in maintaining their territory rather than fighting. Even so, there were frequent skirmishes. The humans and Martian natives became weary of fighting and actually signed a treaty agreeing to peace.
She goes to all the electro horror picture shows.
Picture shows.
She's a savage.
Ugly, ugly, ugly. expect, Commander.
By a lender or a jet
consult,
we just know what happened. So that he will yield. Eliminate dangerous personnel. I won't consult Wiles. I'm putting you in command of the spaceship.
Satellite for the interception of gamma rays. It's practically a monument. You know that thing must be 100 years old.
Telecameras 3 and 4 working. Activate radio contact with the outside. Why in the hell did you send only one man out there?
Well, I thought, Captain,
Come in, Peter. Peter, can you hear me?
Very well, Captain. It's too hazardous to work alone. Re-enter the ship immediately. We'll prepare another crew member to go with you. The orders are that outside, we work in pairs.
Don't worry, Captain.
Screen number 2.
That's an order. If that battery breaks, the acid will destroy your space
shuttle. I know what I'm doing.
Yeah,
late now, Mila.
U-M-C-O-C-H-L-R-U-M-C-O-C-H-L-R-U-M ectoplasm.
Are you sure this spaceship's in the orbit of the satellite's passage?
Not I, but he seems very sure.
Here it is. The satellite has entered our screen.
Give me the data.
Wait a minute, I'm recording. Distance, 180,000 miles. Speed, 73,000 miles per second. Angle of trajectory, alpha 24 degrees. End of the data.
Object identified as the satellite Dana. Satellite is completely safe. No intervention necessary. Proceed on present speed and trajectory. Satellite information now programmed. Distance, 180,000 miles.
Speed, we're lucky. 73,000 we don't have to stop second. Until...
What do you think of Captain Hamilton? Don't you think he's a fascinating man? What the hell? What does it mean? She's almost a message coming from space.
Landing the program.
It seems hard to believe.
But in only 20 more hours, we'll be on our way back to one base. You're almost
late. Oh, Marseille, all you think about is vacation.
Captain, our computer is picking up a strange signal. Yes, sir, you better
go. It's impossible. The computer's got to be wrong.
I will report you.
Report to me as soon as you have anything.
The damn signals, the damn signals are damaging Earth's radio and video systems. I'm receiving solicitations from all over the world. Washington and Moscow have already called me 3 times.
Well, Colonel Altman, it's lucky for us that you're here.
Yes, sir. Let's get down to facts. What disposition of Wiz here?
Wiz affirms that behind this strange signal is an alien intelligence that knows all, and there's danger. Wiz orders us to find the emission source and destroy it.
Good. Send an airship at once.
Thank you. I don't feel that Hamilton is right for the situation.
Hamilton is to be discarded.
Let me go, Commander. Stop this wrangling. Wiz will decide. Captain Hamilton will go and do what he'll be ordered to do. No, I haven't the right crew to undertake such a dangerous journey. We've just completed a mission lasting 6 months and are due for rotation in less than 24 hours. Continuously by journalists from all over the world. Think it over.
I'm sorry, Commander. No member of my crew wants to be a hero. And the normal leave is going to be fine without a promotion. And tell that hunk of metal that MK-31 is returning home.
Captain Hamilton, I think Dr. Jane Fraser would like to speak with you.
Hello, Fred.
Hello, Jane Fraser. It's been a long time.
I won't try to talk you into changing your mind. I only ask that you behave justly. Allow the crew to choose. It's the only democratic way, I feel. That certainly does seem the fairest way to handle this, doesn't it? Hi, Richard.
Hi. How long?
Whatever.
Violent or gentle?
You decide.
We'll be right back.
To Commander Armstrong, it's urgent.
Spaceship MK-31 has to speak with Commander Armstrong. It's urgent. Commander Armstrong is coming.
What's happening, Captain?
Our radar is picking up two strange metallic bodies. I presume they're spaceships.
Spaceships in that part of space? They could be asteroids. They've got to be asteroids.
No asteroids could vary their speed like that. They're being controlled somehow.
Captain, try to find out what's happening. And remember, they're not terrestrial spaceships. That is, if they are spaceships. There's a way to get an answer to that. Activate the scanners.
Executed.
The two objects are now in our cameras. They'll be on your base scanner momentarily. Transfer everything to base Orion.
And they're really spaceships. There just isn't any other possibility.
Establish contact.
Negative contact.
Hamilton, try again. Try with all possible ways of communications. Try with the radio, too. Wait, let us contact Wiles. He'll know what to do.
Ella, interrupt contact with base. Mila, analyze the spaceship on our computer. Ask data about the crew and their weapons in terms of absolute probability.
Data insufficient.
In other words, we'll have to be content with a relative probability.
Unmanned spaceships armed with long-range disintegrators. 70% chance.
Battle speed. Activate disintegrators. Coordinate direction rays. Activate laser. Mass range, 50 miles.
Approaching range. 10. 9. 8. 7.
Against the Earth.
What are you talking about? There's been no attack against our planet.
We've all seen a spaceship. Do you think MK-31 has been hit as part of some weird game?
Will you please stop misrepresenting facts? A space skirmish does not mean that Earth is in peril and that we've been attacked.
That spaceship out there could have weapons.
Our bases didn't sight anything that could make us dread an attack.
Why have you already given the alert signal to all the bases?
Oh, well, because... Now, we'll be quiet. That is a military secret.
Yes, sir. The public must know about that ship. We may be facing the vanguard of a whole fleet.
Damn, that's enough. Get out of here. I won't answer any more questions.
Where's the communicator over here? The Earth is in danger.
I
Captain, I can't reactivate contact with Earth. The auxiliary engines are too weak. They don't have sufficient power.
Activate videos 14 and 7.
And 17 and 6.
Gravitational force is increasing fast.
The angle's drift coincides with the planet's axis. We're being attracted by its gravitational force. We can't stop the fall. We'll be smashed to bits.
Ask computer for force landing data.
Insufficient energy available. Impossible to enter orbit at such high speed. Six minutes before impact.
You must stop the descent instantly.
Activate vaporizers.
It's no good, Captain. There is not enough time left for that now.
Activate vaporizers!
Oxygen 15%, azo 70%. Atmosphere and gravity similar to Earth's. This zone of the planet will stay in shadow another 45 Earth days.
The men in charge of space research get ready to leave in the module.
The rest of you remain on board.
My compliments, Captain. You're the first man to set foot on this planet. We're outcasts on a lost planet in space, but at last we have something firm under our feet.
Planet offers a wonderful opportunity for study.
Yeah!
Station is in here, in this cave. They're signals addressed only to us. They originate here.
An inert rock that transmits signals from Earth. This sphere is the sending station.
Our quartz crystals have this property, but they have to be activated. Anyway, the power in ours is limited. There's some kind of message.
Yes, and I think it's directed toward us.
It seems a little clear.
Someone is near us. I'm almost sure there is.
That's crazy. There's no one in here.
We've got to keep checking. We've got to find out who or what's sending that message. The signals feel stronger to me. Hello, Control. Record everything you see here.
The videotape's running already.
Those strange signals are so baffling.
Let me know if you need the rest of the crew.
Okay. Let's look around.
Captain, for us here. The city's an atomic stockpile.
The radioactivity is continuing to rise.
back to the ship and consult the program. Itor, we can destroy the enemy, but we have to go back to the ship first. We have no choice. Itor, the weapons we need are on board, and we can't do without them. The woman will stay with us. There's no alternative.
Initially, that generator might not be able to take it.
I said maximum, Segura.
We might blow up.
We'll blow up if we stay here.
The generator isn't all the way up yet.
I said full power, Segura.
Sir, it's impossible until the generator's
up. Stop giving the excuses and do it. Here I am.
I'm okay now. I'll take over, Segura. Go back to Greta.
Give me more on the starboard engines.
He's about to leave everything. sentence two. I'll give you a full report when you reach the base. Here's our guest.
He looks terrific. He seems like one of us.
Request coordination with Base Orion. Give data to the computer.
Our connection with Earth is interrupted again. Captain, perhaps in the corridor.
Better check the computer.
When her 20 years of service were up, she spent several weeks on the moon for a reverse aging process so that she could be returned to Earth and inserted back into his original timeline. 2017. Her memories of her 20 years of service were suppressed and did not return to her for many years.
Breakdown due to sabotage.
Activate interior video 1 and emergency generator.
What the hell are you doing here, Odo? I told you to look after Greta.
No need to. Let's leave.
energy of your race, I am still powerful.
Mila, you can't do anything for Itor.
Shall I get her, Captain?
No, Holden. I know how to get rid of that monster. You stay here at the control console. Open the door. Mila, you've got to get out of here.
I have a little surprise for the youngest member of your crew.
Well, look, Peter, there's your baby.
Ask that hunk of metal if we're on the right course and how long it'll take us to arrive.
Wait,
Get ugly with me.
How long?
Whatever.
Violent or gentle?
You decide.